God, dude.
That's awesome.
Sunday Gunday. What's going on, everyone? Back with another episode of Stuff and Things. I'm doing something a little bit different today. Some last minute plans came up. I got a DM on Instagram from a friend who you guys might know, you have not seen on my channel before, but it is Mr.
Hi.
John Patton.
Hi. Hi. How's everybody doing?
You guys know John if you watch TDC News, the only gun news that you actually care about.
I'm proud of you.
That's good.
I'm proud of you.
I watch your videos.
That's good.
I don't watch many gun channels, but after I met you, I obviously watch your stuff. So
well, thank you.
If you guys want to check out his channel, of course, the link is in the description down below.
Yeah, you should definitely do that because we do things a little bit different than everybody else. Focus on news, gun law, kind of way more technical stuff than a lot of the guys. Like Talon's all about, you know, the fun stuff and being a cool guy.
You guys don't see him in like the vloggy type stuff, so
ever. I wish I should
They don't hear you swear, they don't see any of that really, right?
Oh my god, holy f.
So this will be kind of cool if you are a fan of TGC News. Adam is also here. We're doing some testing and some shooting for his channel. I don't even know, actually I know one of the guns, but I'm gonna have John go over some of the stuff that we're shooting today and should be a pretty good time.
Yeah, it's gonna be awesome, man. I'm glad you came out. It's gonna be fun.
Thanks for having me, man.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
I brought the STI today because if people don't see it in a video or a post on Instagram, they're like, yo, is that thing? Yeah, did you sell it? Is
it
not running?
Sell it, bro?
Maybe we can take you for a ride later.
Oh, dude, I'm all about it. Do I look cool this way?
Oh, yeah.
Just flex.
A little more leg.
Oh, hold on. Look at that, dude. F***ing Pennsylvania tan.
Pennsylvania tan.
All right, so what these guys were just shooting and filming with is a Palmetto State Armory 224 Valkyrie, kind of similar to the custom Radical that I did a video on a couple weeks ago. Every once in a while, I see comments in the section looking at more budget style rifles, especially Palmetto State. So not saying this is a bad thing, it could just be a one-off type of issue. However, check out what it did. It's a little hard to see because it is bright out here. However, the top of the gas tube here is kind of like peened over because of the bolt carrier not lining up with it for some reason.
We don't know why things didn't line up. You know, this is what it is. It's a factory rifle. You know, we're just going out to blast on it. And look, he's struggling to get it out because what happens is when that thing got smashed, when it contacted the gas tube, it pushed out on that tube and therefore the gas key can no longer fit over it properly.
So this is how things go when we film gun content like this. Obviously, my very first episode of Sunday Gunday, when I made this like a spin-off of the whole series, that rifle broke. I had an extractor like shear off and it was floating around in the lower somewhere.
Yay! Gun videos!
I haven't even shot that gun. It was a 7.5-inch AR pistol since I filmed that video.
Once you get a bad taste in your mouth,
it's like
I don't even want to bother wasting my time because it's probably going to break again.
Yeah.
That's not always the case, but it feels that way.
Yeah.
You got like discouraged about it.
So, whatever. Everything that we're doing is all learning experience, testing the stuff out, letting you know how it is so you guys don't have to.
Things break. The 224 Valkyrie is now inoperable because the gas key is impacting the gas tube in the upper receiver. We put down a few groups. We're gonna go take a look at that. We checked the brass, so maybe a primer had come out, something wacky. Doesn't look like that. Not really sure what's going on. It's gonna go back to Palmetto and we'll see what they have to say about it. But for now, we cannot continue the test. Let's go take a look at the groups.
Like this is your job or something.
Yeah.
You've done that a couple times.
A few times. Not good. Groups suck.
Now I know I can't just show B-roll of this gun without talking about it at least a little bit. I know you guys are curious about the gun. So Adam is going to be shooting
the Q-Fix. That's a good looking gun. yourself. All right, come down an inch. So come down 0.5. Left 0.2. Bye-bye.
So this is the Fix Rifle by Q. You guys may have seen a honey badger before, not on this channel, but they're pretty popular, growing in popularity for sure. Q also makes the Trash Panda suppressor, which is good for this. Do you have one of those?
No, I don't have any of the silencers currently, but the Trash Panda and the Thunder Chicken would be the
Thunder
the
Chicken ones would be sweet. So what makes this thing cool?
Well, there's a lot of things that make this thing
other
cool.
Than aesthetics, because this thing is a badass looking rifle.
Yeah, so the rifle itself was completely designed from scratch. What they did was they did a one-piece receiver housing there. They took a lot of inspiration from pistol builds and other projects that they've worked on before to come up with the Fix itself. One of the things you'll notice is the bolt itself, it rides on a rail here. It's a real short throw lever. Essentially, it's really easy moving. There was a lot of engineering in the way things went into the bolt itself that I honestly don't recall all of. What I do remember from when I went up there to build it, Nick, the engineer, was explaining to me that they did as much as they could to reduce the amount of mass in, I believe it was the firing pin moving when you pull the trigger, in order to kind of make everything as smooth as possible in there. It does have a folding stock that's still a little tight, but so you can collapse it down, and if you didn't have the bipod out, obviously, with cool. A sling, you know, nice small gun to carry around hunting. Yep. Just the gun itself, I think, is right around 6 pounds. So it's a light gun. The trigger pull on this one is about 2.5.
Flat.
Yeah, it's an in-house trigger. It's balanced in-house. So what that means is it's a drop-safe mechanism that's built into the trigger itself. We took the trigger and you stuck it on like just a rod. You spun it, and it would never land the same way twice. So it was perfectly balanced, and the idea is that when you drop, if you were to drop the gun, there's no inertia from the trigger itself that would cause the hammer to,
gotcha.
To fire. This one's got a Bartline 20 inch barrel on it. It's a 6.5 Creedmoor, and then as you can see, we stuck a EOTech Voodoo 5-25.
That thing is sweet.
On
as well.
On a Geissele. It's a 34 millimeter mount. That's a 20 MOA. It's their super precision mount, and then the AccuTac bipod that I am currently borrowing from John.
And these are also available in 308, I believe.
Yeah, they're also available in 308. So there's the Fix, which is in 6.5 Creedmoor 308. The Fix Mini, they did pre-orders on. That is in 224 Valkyrie is what they did it in. They're going to be coming as pistols as well as longer models. They're doing 300 blackout in the Mini Fix, and then they're working on an 8.6 Creedmoor.
So I have not had a chance to shoot this yet, but I know my friends down at Panda Tactical have two of these. They had one in 6.5 and 308. Not sure if they still have them, but I will definitely get my hands on one in the future because I'm sure you guys want to see a video
on
this.
We're gonna get you on the gun before we leave here today.
Okay.
Get some rounds through it.
All right, you guys might get a first mag impression then today.
Water up.
Should just hold center?
Yep. It's all about the flamingo shirt.
Right. Low, a dirty front.
tough, man. I don't know how you got those two shots.
I don't either.
That's wild.
It was just walking all over.
Yeah, I was all around it.
All right, guys, so my quick first impressions of the Q. This thing is awesome. Definitely recoils more than I thought. I mean, same with what these guys were saying as well. But super smooth, the trigger pull feels great. It's very smooth back to the wall. It's like, it's almost just like, kind of like hanging there. This thing would be great with a Thunder Chicken on the end or the Trash Panda. I think I would pick this up in the 6.5 Creedmoor just because the LRR video that I did, that thing is more of a traditional style rifle, although it is a chassis type of gun. I like the older caliber, but 6.5 Creedmoor ballistically is very, very good, obviously. So this thing's kind of modern with a newer round. I think this is a pretty cool platform.
Now, what are you shooting?
This is a Bighorn Armory 500 Auto Max. Let me pull out one of the rounds for you guys. I believe that's a 350 grain soft point. It's essentially
shooting my pinky out of the barrel.
So it's a big old bullet. It's essentially a 500 Magnum with the rim trimmed off to work in a semi-auto platform. That, and I've got a 50 caliber suppressor on the end of this, so it should make things pretty interesting. The other thing that I think is really odd about this is it's actually an AR-10 receiver set, and they machined it. The magwell's actually got a like kind of a block in here to take AR-15 size magazines. Definitely not a common thing, but we'll see how it runs. We'll see how she does.
I know it's gonna recoil like a lot.
All right, let's see if we got it on target.
The recoil on this thing is surprisingly not that bad.
It's really not. The can helps a ton.
Held like a hair lower that time.
Yeah, that's good. It's better.
Dude, that recoil is fantastic.
I know.
How do you feel?
Feel good.
Feel more American now?
Pretty American, yeah.
Here we go. How many rounds you got in there? Four rounds. You should shoot them as quickly as you can.
Okay, you don't gotta tell me twice.
I think you got the berm. There you go.
Heard that.
That thing smacks the crap out of that steel.
Yeah.
Yep.
Hit. 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 Dead center.
Hit.
Hits, man.
Still right, hold left. Good hit.
High right. Hit. All right, next thing we have on the list today is an AK.
Yup. This is a Mod Outfitters, MOD Outfitters AK. They are something that is not sold very widely. And then we've got a Dead Air Wolverine suppressor on there. This rifle actually belongs to Adam back there in the background. And we're gonna blast it a little bit.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right, so one of the other things in the gun that wasn't covered right in the beginning is it does have the K&S adjustable piston system in it. So typically ARs have adjustable gas blocks or adjustable gas keys and whatnot, and AKs are just over gas as hell. So K&S came out with a really neat solution here that the piston itself, you can adjust the gas flow on it. So I thought I had it dialed in a little bit ago, but I guess not. So we're gonna give it a couple clicks more gas because it was short stroking here. So to adjust it, it's real simple. You just take this and twist it. So we're gonna give it, it's still hot, three clicks there and see if that stops that short stroking from happening.
Sweet. Let's do it.
I'm gonna shoot it at 50 real quick.
I had to. I'm sorry, I had to.
Had to. It's not a video without a mag dump.
Yeah, I had to.
What are we doing now?
So we're about to do a live unboxing on the TGC Facebook of this one of one Browning Buckmark carbine that has been integrally suppressed by KG Made. There is literally nobody else in the world that has one like this. So we're gonna take it out of the package and put a couple rounds through it for funsies.
This is going to be live on their Facebook. I don't use Facebook that much, but if you wanna check them out on their link in the description down below.
Awesome. Cut towards yourself. Cut towards yourself. Safety sometimes.
Safety sometimes.
Yeah. All right, so I have yet to see this. Nobody else here knows what this is gonna look like. There's the paperwork.
Man.
Oh, I got some KG Made swag. Yeah, swag
wood
is good.
And leather.
So this is pretty legit. Check this out. So what's unique about this is he took the factory barrel and basically put a baffle stack here. I'll see if I can get the end cap off. Oh, look, it'll come right off so we can see what this really looks like. This is the cool, exciting part. All right, so there's that, and then the sleeve.
This is similar to the Gemtech Mist.
Right, but there is nobody that makes one for one of these.
Okay.
Like, nothing exists for this gun. It's super. It's not a super common gun, and then to have an integral suppression system, again, not common. Check it out. Ooh, super lightweight.
Yeah. John is nice enough to give me the first mag through this one of one gun. Pretty excited. I don't think I've ever shot an integrally suppressed 22 before. No ears. Oh my god, dude.
That's awesome.
Oh, and it runs like a champ.
Dude, so quiet. That is awesome.
I think the rain hitting the roof is louder than the gun.
This thing's rad. This is so cool.
John with the bonus mag.
Bonus. You good, Adam?
All right, here we go.
That's pretty good. Nothing like it. One of one. Super cool to have.
I am officially jealous. I don't think we're in Kansas anymore.
No, we're not.
All right, guys, we're back just to say goodbye. Hopefully you enjoyed this quick impromptu gun content in the middle of the week.
Whatever this is.
whatever this video turned out to be. It was fun. Ended up getting a little wet, but we lucked out on the weather earlier in the day, so.
Yeah, we had some fun, man.
Had some fun.
Did some cool stuff.
I think in the future, I got to get you to come up to my range and do a proper Sunday gun day.
Absolutely.
Because I think we could have a lot of fun doing that.
I think between you and I, we've got some really, really interesting stuff to play with.
Especially like the 22 you just got.
Yeah.
Dude,
a
Sunday gun day on that would be awesome.
Let's do it.
We'll do that in the future sometime.
Yeah.
If you guys don't know John, now you do. Check out his channel in the description down below or click this card right up here. Check it out for yourself. A lot of good information on there. Definitely different styles, but I like the cross collaboration type of stuff.
I think it's a lot of fun for us to, you know, just hang out and
enjoy what we enjoy together. You know, we actually have a lot more in common than guns too, which is great.
A lot of stuff. Cars.
Yeah.
All sorts of stuff like that.
Yeah, man.
So that's it for today. If you're new to the channel, consider clicking subscribe. I make new videos every week. That's all for today. I'll talk to you guys in the next one.